Okay, now let's look at an example where we have more than one pairs. So this is one example, this is one example. Here you can say we have three ones and one zero. Here also we have three ones, one zero, but the arrangement is slightly different. So if you will see this one, the pairing is possible. You can see these two guys will pair, but there is one more pair which can be possible because of this one. Okay, this one will try to pair it with some other one. Now this one is already is in pair, but again it will make pair just for the sake of this one. Okay, so this is another pair. And why we made this kind of pair? Because either you can make top down or left right. Okay, you saw that there was another one to make a pair, and hence you have total two pairs now. Similarly, here you will see you have one pair here, and this one is left out, and which can make a pair of two like this. Okay, so function value will be, because of one pair, this pair one, where b bar, it is b bar, remember we are looking for min terms, not max term. So this is b bar, and plus, because of this pair, it is a bar. Okay, similarly here, if you will see, the function value will be, because of this guy it is b, because of this guy it is, common is a. Okay, so even if you will do the Boolean algebra, you will get the same thing, a bar b bar plus a bar b plus a b bar. Okay, a bar you can take common, so you will get a bar plus a b bar. You can use the rule a and a bar plus b bar. So this will be one, so you will get a bar plus b bar, which is same. Here also if you will do a bar b plus a b bar plus a b, now this will give you, you can take this common, a plus a bar b, and then you will get a plus a bar into a plus b, so which will ultimately give you a plus b. Okay, which is same as this. So you don't have to do all this stuff, and you are directly getting the reduced form of function. Plus you know how to handle more than two or more than one pair if you have. Okay, now you can also go by product of sum approach. This is what we have done, is sum of product of sum approach. If you will do, then you will have only one term. You can know there is no reduction at all. So just this example was showing you how to handle more than one pairs. Now we will go for if you have pair of four. Okay, in this also you can have pair of four. Now in the similar fashion, you can see the pair of four here, all the values of f are one. So you won't do something like pairing of two, because the pair of four is possible, and always the pair of four will be dominating the pair of two. Likewise, pair of 8 will dominate pair of 4. Okay, we will see in the future that if you will go for more variables, then pair of 8 will also come. So right now, if you will see, you can make this kind of pair, two pairs, or this kind of pair. These are all wrong. Okay, this is possible, but this won't give you the minimized function. Okay, you will still have to do some minimization after writing the function. Hence, this is valid, but it is not allowed, because there is a group of four which is possible, these four. And you can say, see all the values, a is also changing, b is also changing, the function values are all one, so f is equal to one. Okay, so this is the pair of four. You can see, just an example I want to give. Now you can also go by a pair of four with all zeros. Okay, in POS form also you will have this. So if you will make like this 0 0 0 0 and you go a b 0 1 0 1, you can make this pair of 4, but all the function values will be 0, hence the function value is 0. Here the pairing of 2 is not allowed, okay, if you do the pair like this, if you player like this, this is not allowed, although it is possible. Or you are pairing like this or this, it is not allowed, they are not allowed. So just an example of how we pair in 4, and this is the maximum you can reach with 2 variables. Okay, now we will extend this idea of pairing and writing the function with 3 variables, 4 variables, 5 variables. Okay.